How do the braces move the teeth? It's a good question. I'll try to answer that for you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Braces Guide. I am Dr. Dave. I'm a board-certified orthodontist, and I'm going to try to answer a question. It's actually a very good question. How do the braces move the teeth? Well, it's actually a very complicated question because there's a lot involved in how braces move the teeth. We've got engineering, different metals, the wires, brackets, physics is involved. We've got different forces that are on the teeth, on the wires, on the brackets. We've got chemistry, the bonding materials that are used to glue brackets to the teeth. We also have biology, so the cellular process that's involved in moving teeth. We're adding bone on one side, we're taking away bone on the other. That whole process, we're reorganizing the tissue around the teeth. So it's a very complicated answer. So the first thing I want to talk about are the braces themselves. The braces are glued directly onto the teeth by your orthodontist, and they're glued on in a very specific position on the tooth. The components of a bracket are the base of the bracket, which is the backside, which is the part that actually adheres to the tooth. And then you have the slot, which is the center portion of the bracket. That's where the wire goes in. And then you have the wings of the bracket. And the wings are the outer part of the bracket that allow the orthodontist or the assistant to put the colored tie on there. And that colored tie is what holds the wire into the bracket. So the wire is what actually transmits the forces to the bracket, which then, because it's stuck to the tooth, moves the tooth. And there's different types of wires. The initial wires are usually very small, very flexible. So when I bend it, it flexes very easily. And the other component of this wire, this is called a nitinol wire. When I bend it, it wants to go back to its original position, its original shape. It's a very small wire and applies a very gentle force to the teeth. And this is really good for that initial stage when you're just starting the alignment process, because you don't want really heavy forces. You want something that can weave in and out of the crooked teeth. And that's what helps to provide that straightening process. Later on, once the teeth start to straighten a little bit more, then we start to use thicker wires. So this is an example of a little bit thicker wire. It goes from the nitinol wires, which are flexible and retain their shape, to steel wires, which when you bend them, the wire permanently forms into that shape. And so there's some reasons why we want to use that kind of a wire later on. So if we have some teeth that are a little bit crooked here, so we'll just draw some incisors. And then when the orthodontist places the braces, they're going to place them in a very specific location. This is that wire I was talking about that has that property where when you bend it, it has that tendency to always go back to that original shape. If we take a wire like that and we put it into the brackets, we can bend it and form it into those brackets very easily. So it applies a relatively low force, so it's not too painful, but it also applies enough of a force to start that movement. So if we look at where the forces are applied on the bracket, for example, on this leftmost tooth, you can see there's going to be an upward force. On the center tooth, there's going to be this downward force. And on the side tooth, you're going to have an upward force. So over time, what we'll find is that these teeth will start to straighten out. As we start to get the teeth straighter, then we start to move up into bigger wires. So we start off with a small, round, flexible wire, and then if we look at a cross-section of a different wire, it could be, for example, a square wire or maybe even a rectangular wire. And these are magnified, of course. But if we take a rectangular size wire and we fit it into the slot, it's going to fit much more fully. It's going to engage into that slot much more. The brackets have a built-in prescription. So each bracket will have a different shape to that inner slot. So for example, this is an exaggeration, but if I take a round wire and I put it into this slot, you can see it's not going to have much of an effect because it's not applying many forces. you'll get some of the alignment forces as I diagrammed above, but you may not get some of the more intricate forces until you get into the thicker wire. So once we get into this size wire, it engages into that slot, and then you've got some more forces. You have not only up and down or angle or tipping type forces, you also have what's called torque. And a torque force is what's built into the bracket slot. Let's enhance that slot even more. So I'm just going to draw a very large bracket. So if we put a wire into here, and it's a rectangular wire, it's going to fit into this slot much more. And now you have little mini forces that are applied. Not only the larger forces, you also have these forces that are applied now in this direction, upwards on the back side and then downwards on the other side. So those forces will create a rotational type of a force. So you may have heard about tightening when you come in for orthodontic adjustment appointments. And the tightening is actually this whole process. It's just the wire being placed into the bracket. The colors are being placed on the wings, and that forces the wire into the slot, and then that's what applies the tension or the forces that we can use to move the teeth. So it's actually not the orthodontist going in there and cranking anything or using a wrench or tightening anything necessarily. It's more the wire that's applying the force to the bracket, which then you feel as kind of this tension on your teeth. I hope this was helpful. Let me know if you have any more questions in the comments below. If you liked the video, go ahead and hit a like. If you want to be notified of future videos when I put them out, go ahead and hit subscribe and the notification, and you'll be sure to be notified when future videos come out. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.